Hello and good afternoon. I'm your host and a very friendly one at that for sure for today. We're here today at Nature's Basket at the Worli Center. I'm Chef Rakhi Vaswani. I'm going to give a little introduction about myself, but before that, a very, very warm welcome to everyone. Aaj bahut sare log yahan aaye hain and it's a really lovely feeling. And I've got some amazing women jo ekdam apne character form mein aane wale hain. I'm really super excited to hear their story. The topic for today is it's all about the women. So all the men there, do not panic. Trust me, we do need your support and obviously all the love and affection. But it's all about the women today. Super happy and excited about that. And so the concept is hashtag women who challenge, and I have some women among me over here who've been challenging people, challenging their work and pushing themselves forward. So coming back to me, main Chef Rakhi Vaswani, for all of you who are followers at Nature's Basket, jante honge maine bahut sare aise events kiye hain, mostly maine bahut sare master classes kiye hain, and today I am here and I am introducing some other women in this industry jinhone bahut sare karname kiye hain. I'm really excited about that. So kya kahu Chef Rakhi ke bare mein, she is a mother, she's an entrepreneur, and always my kids keep, you know, troubling me on that word every time if I just go a little haywire here and there, but yeah, so I'm remembering them. Have a very, very supportive family, my parents, my mom, my mother-in-law, sister-in-law, all of them, and the husband, the biggest support. So I gave up my rollicking career in the culinary world, in cooking, a couple of years back. 10 साल का sabbatical लिया, and then I came back into the industry with all the possible international training I think I wanted. And we started Palette Colony Academy. Yes, many of you know me as being a host on TV. I've done a couple of shows. In fact, recently, lockdown mein. So this concept with Nature's Basket has picked up is really very, very fascinating, very close to my heart, because we actually did a show on TLC and Discovery, Plates of Flavor. So humne lockdown ke challenges par, we got a lot of people who were never in this industry and came into this industry and made an amazing career. For all those who don't know, I run Palette Culinary Academy, a premier most culinary institute jahan hum UK accreditations laate hain from City and Guilds and CTH. For all those who want to become professional chefs, whatever their age, whatever the career, if you want to hop over, we're right there in that drum. Enough said about me. I think you know about me. If you're still not following me on Instagram, do it right now. That was a clue for everyone to move. But yet I didn't see a few of them moving their fingers here, but I'm sure the audience there is doing it. So enough talking about me. I think you already know. As they say, you know, you should be known for your work. Let me now start introducing our panelists for today. And I would like to welcome all four of these ladies who are really dynamic, young, enterprising, and you know, want to learn a little bit about their journey, what they've gone through. Is pandemic ne unhe kya kya sikhaya hai? Is something I would like to know. So a very, very warm welcome to all four of you.
Thank you.
Before I take down their names and introduce them, I'd like to know from the audience, any of the women over here have their own business in the food industry over here? Anyone? Yes, can we see some hands? Yes, I see a hand there. We see a hand here. Right in front, we have someone. Yes. And all those who are supporting these women also, you are also in the business, right?
Yeah.
Right, exactly. So can we see those hands there, please? Yeah. That's lovely, lovely, lovely. How many of you all are planning to start something? Koi shuru karne? आंटी जी वहाँ पे आप कुछ जरूर अच्छा बनाते होंगे, आई एम श्योर. तो यू नो, मैं तो हमेशा अपने मॉम और यू नो मातनों को भी बोलती हूँ कि बस एक, मेरी मॉम इन लॉ बहुत अच्छी कोकियाँ बनाती है, तो ऐसे एक कोकी काउंटर हो जाए ना. सही है ना? तो कुछ आप अगर इंस्पायर कर रहे हैं तो शायद आज के हमारे टॉपिक में एक न्यू बिजनेस इमर्ज हो जाए, विल बी वेरी हैप्पी. यस. और एंड में एक पिक्चर भी लेंगे हम, आप और मैं, एक सेल्फी. ओके. So going on, and we have in the audience my sweet little mom who has just got a smartphone right there, and she really loves to use it with a lot of trouble, of course. Sweet of her. Yes. So yes, there are many women over here who want to start their own business, and kyun nahi, right? I mean, why not?
Okay.
So we'll start with the introduction of our main heroines of today. I wouldn't have said heroes. So heroines of today is what we're going to do is start introducing them, and then thodi unki kahani sunte hain unhi ki zubani. So first we've got Tulsi. Yes, we've got Tulsi, and you have a partner as well, Tulsi, right?
Yes. She's my sister, Pooja.
Oh, lovely. So Tulsi and Pooja, and would you like to tell me a little about your business? And aapi ki zubani, definitely this business has grown in this pandemic, am I right?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Hi guys. So my sister and I started Domates in sometime in November, and again, because of the pandemic, it was something that all of us have started in pandemic, and we had a lot of challenges to be faced with it. And it was quite difficult, but this idea of starting edible cookie dough was something that was pondering in our heads since quite a few years. And we think that COVID has actually given us this opportunity, and COVID has become a boon to us to actually start and execute Domates, you know. So first, I just want to understand, when you hear the name Domates, what comes in your mind? Like, what is the thought? Like, what do you think Domates is all about? Like, I just want to understand from all of you guys. Duh, you're my mate. You got it.
Yeah.
So anyone from the audience? No? Okay, so
take them through.
Yeah, okay, so Domates, we make edible cookie dough. And this is, like she said, this is an idea that we got from New York. We'll talk a lot more about it after the introduction. Yeah. But yeah, we'll take you through it with it. Thank you.
Thank you. Do we have some tastings going on?
Yeah. We asked them.
No.
Wasn't I supposed to be asked?
No. Nah. You're getting it.
Okay.
It's coming home delivered.
Okay. So next up, we've got Hetal with us. Yeah. And Hetal is not a chef, she tells me. That's the name of her brand. So let's head over to Hetal.
Yeah, hi. Can you hear me?
Yes, they can hear you.
Hi. So, not a chef, as the name says, that I am not a chef like her. She is a chef, but I'm not. It's because I do not have any, I like to call it not a chef, because I do not have a professional degree of being a chef. But I started, I mean, something like this, which was very, very impromptu, because cooking has been a part of my life since childhood. It's since school that I've been cooking, and I never thought of taking it professionally. But after all these years, and because of COVID, you gave it a thought and want to, you know, take it further as, you know, as professionally, you know, do things professionally. And that's why, that's how Not a Chef began. And you'll know the story.
Yeah.
Yeah. More.
Awesome. So next up, we have a lovely fashion designer who gave it all up to become a chef, right? And this is inspired by her, we'll talk a little about her story, but it's, the inspiration comes from her mother. So Chandni, if you'd like to tell us, we've got Chandni with us, and can you please tell us a little about yourself and your business? First introduce yourself and your business.
Hi, this is Chandni from Head Over Meals by Chandni. I started this in May during the pandemic, and it was a journey which started through my mom. Of her inherited recipes, I started baking. I started cooking for the first time in COVID, and it just started because of her. And yeah, you know the story.
Awesome. So, guys, can we just have a round of applause for all these panelists here who've really done something wonderful in this pandemic? From first time chefs to not a chef to my main. Alright, so we'd like to ask a few questions to them. So what I want to know now, I want to go digging deep, aur mujhe janna hai inke business ke bare mein. And first of all, I'd like to, I think we'll all agree ki, we would like to thank Nature's Basket for bringing, for recognizing this effort, for bringing all these women, you know, bringing us on this platform and making us यू नो समटाइम्स इट्स सो इंपॉर्टेंट टू बी हर्ड राइट एम आई राइट गाइस
या
कोई कोई सुनता है आपकी बात तो वो खुशी होती है दैट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड नेचर ने बिना कहे हमारी बात हमें सुनाने के लिए ये मौका दिया सो थैंक यू सो मच टू नेचर्स बास्केट एंड यू नो देयर बी लॉट ऑफ अदर पीपल हु आर वाचिंग अस राइट नाउ ऑन द फेसबुक एंड इंस्टाग्राम लाइव सो गाइस यू आर जस्ट गोना गेट वायरल नाउ सो आई एम रियली लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू दैट सो आई एम गोना स्टार्ट आस्किंग अ फ्यू क्वेश्चंस बिकॉज़ आई रियली वांट टू नो कैसे बिजनेस हुआ क्या हुआ व्हाट इज ऑन I need to know it all. Shall I then learn a few things from them also? And we'll just exchange a few thoughts. And then I'll come back to the audience. Agar aapko kuch puchna hai, so we'd love to answer those questions also. So sabse pehle I'll go back to Tulsi and Pooja. What made you start your business? And what is the thought process behind it? Yes, strike hua. I know you guys were literally traveling to NYC. Yeah. And among the shopping bags, you just wanted a sugar rush. And you took that all. And then you made that into a business.
No.
So I want to know it all.
So you're partly correct. We did have a lot of shopping bags. But like, you know, we were traveling through and then we saw this rolling long queue. And she's like, no, let's go. Let's see more places. And I stopped by because I was like, I've never seen such a queue before, you know. And I was very intrigued by it because I wanted to know what it's all about. And then we saw a store right opposite which was selling cookie dough and I had never had cookie dough. So I was like, you know what, I want to stay here. I want to experience what this madness is all about. So we waited in line for 2 hours. I got a lot of galis from everybody.
And
but
honestly, this line is something that we've seen over here only when we are at Siddhivinayak. Okay, very honestly,
we stood there for 2 hours straight just for her, satisfying her craving.
Okay,
no, but then that's the business.
That is.
Let's not be very vocal about it because Tata Chana will royalty mount there. Because idea wahi se aaya hai. Yes, a little more, please.
Yeah.
So once we went in, since like I said, we never had edible cookie dough before, but once we went in and we had it, the first thought that came to my mind is, ये तो इंडिया लाना ही है यू नो लाइक वी रियली हैव टू गेट दिस
व्हेन यू ब्रॉट इट बैक टू इंडिया तो जब इंडिया में वापस आए यू हैड नेवर डेफिनेटली एंटर्ड द किचन एंड नाउ यू एंटर्ड योर मदर्स रूम व्हाट वाज द मेस यू क्रिएटेड शी इज लाफिंग फ्रॉम देयर ओनली बिकॉज़ शी हैड टू डू ऑल द क्लीनिंग अप शी गिव यू दोस डायलॉग्स ये सब क्या है गेट द होल एक्ट टुगेदर
दैट्स द एवरीडे थिंग लाइक एवरी टाइम वी एंटर द किचन
सो व्हाट हाउ डिड दैट जर्नी बिकम व्हाट वाज द रिएक्शन ऑफ द फैमिली व्हाट वर योर ट्रायल प्रोसेसेस लाइक Did you come to Nature's Basket shop? I hope you did. Yes. So you definitely did come here. Because obviously these kind of things, you need those kind of ingredients, right? So can I know a little about that?
So we started this. Actually, the journey goes a little longer back to, I think, April. When we started entering the kitchen because we're a lot more at home now and we started experimenting with the chef within us, you know, naturally. And the mother, of course, wasn't very happy at that moment because of the mess that we were creating. But we started documenting all the food that we started making at that point of time. So we started a food blog and we started putting it all out there. And while doing all of that, you know, we decided that why not experiment with making the edible cookie dough because you know we really loved it and we want everyone else to have it
and
that's how it started
so definitely mom had a hard time with us like it was there was this one random night when both of us were actually sitting and discussing that you know this is a perfect time we could actually grab this opportunity and start something by ourselves because We've cooked a lot and she loves sweets and being a sweet girl, she's just like, this is the time to start something new altogether, you know. So there was this one day we started thinking about it and next day we actually had a round table conference with our family explaining exactly what we want to do and how do we want to go about it.
There were what are the flavors that came out of it? Can we know a little about what is it that we will expect when we go to, we want to know what is it that we can get, what am I getting, and what are others ordering, and where did you do your knowledge of ingredients, a little bit of that kitchen problem that you faced.
So
what is the strength of the business? how much do you, you know, scale it up? What are you looking at? So can I know a little about that?
Okay. So starting with the flavors, we have 11 scrumptious flavors at the moment. Going from the classic to our signatures, we have chocolate chip, we have Nutella overload, we have Lotus Biscoff. That's something trending with all the chefs and in every category that we have. Then we have peanut butter. We have a wide range, and we could even and also I shouldn't forget this, but we have, like all millennials will know, we have a Jim Jam flavor too. Have you all tried Jim Jam earlier when you were kids?
Yes. Yeah. I think we've all grown up eating Jim Jam.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's honestly the best seller that we have. One of the best sellers that we have. Okay. And you want to take that?
Yeah. What do you do for promotion?
For us, I think because it started online, we've only been focusing so much on social media, because I think today without social media, like, I think nothing functions. Whether you're a small business or a multinational, I think everything is on social media. So social media has been very, very kind to us. And the traditional method of word of mouth worked really well for us. And yeah, that's how we've been going about promoting.
And like she mentioned, we have this, so we started as a food blogger. Back in April, we started as a food blogger. We have this page called Basil Tales. So honestly, that we've grown, in within 3 months time, we've grown really well. And it actually helped us as one of our tactics to grow and to take it up.
So are we looking at funding here now? What's the scale, the business scale? So I'm going to come back to you for that. Let's hear a little from Hetal, because Hetal apparently is an experienced chef who's been cooking from a very young age, and she brings that lineage into the business. So Hetal to matlab uthi thi jab se tab se wo I think kaam kar rahi hai. So you know, let's hear ki Hetal kya kar rahi hai and hum kya kya expect kar sakte hain.
Yeah, so yeah, as you girls have just entered the kitchen, for me it's been my first love sort of a thing. I have been cooking since, I think my first time that I cooked was for my best friend in my 10th or 9th grade, where I made pav bhaji for 25 people. All the school
that
friends were
first.
Coming. And so when I started Not a Chef, that's the first dish that I made. And I gave it to, you know, to introduce my brand, where I gave it and passed it on to all my family and friends, that, you know, as an introduction, and like something as basic as a pav bhaji has been my first dish and how I'm connected with that. So I have been cooking. I remember my mom telling me when I was asking her, like, because now we have questions of how this whole love for cooking has been there. I mean, you know, you don't remember things. So my mom told me that what you used to do as a child is, you went to school and college. When you came back, you did not have the patience to wait till I make something and give it to you. So you always wanted to get into the kitchen, see what's there and make it yourself and eat it.
So I can relate to him with that. I remember while I was growing up, and if you know, in the afternoon now, the food was a little boxy. Everyone loves kisi aur ke ghar ki dal, right? You love kisi aur ke ghar ki dal. So what happens is, yes, sorry, can't hear her. Okay, all right, okay. So everyone loves kisi aur ke ghar ki dal, and I would always want to be. I used to find myself in my whole building. I was the only girl child at that point, and everyone had boys. So this will love me the most, okay? So what happened is the mic clear, I think? Yeah. No, it's clear. So I would love to learn unke ghar mein kya ban raha hai, everyone's recipe here. Right. Jab ghar aati thi dupehar ko, I remember agar kuch boring hota tha, toh I used to go in the kitchen and I used to start cooking. And I used to tell my mom, I'm going to make this pulao for me. And would you eat? Will you eat? And I would ask my chachi, and they would say, okay, we might just taste. And every day I would make something different for me. Soon I found myself. So I used to go for cooking classes with my neighbors who were mom's age when I was 12 years old.
Wow.
So I went for my first cooking class then. And then every day, my first cooking was Chinese, okay?
Yeah.
So I learned that sweet corn soup, and you know how the egg drop happens in that. And I was super excited. Wow, aise banta hai. So every day, khana was just in the dinner. My dad used to say, okay, now you're only going to make dinner.
Yeah. Yeah.
So it was really very blissful for me to learn. I used to go for cooking classes with all of them, and you know, I wanted to just escalate.
It's still now passion, I do the same thing. It's like when I go somewhere and if there is a, you know, food counter even in a wedding, or I travel somewhere and there is a dhaba, I would always sit and chat, or you know, look at that guy, know that recipe, come back, try the same masala.
ये सारे secrets आपसे सीखे और से देखिए इसे अगर ये आपके counter में नजर आ रहा है तो दूर रहना.
No, so that's what my learning is. So yeah. I always observe my mom. I always observe, like I remember, I tell my Masi that I learned pav bhaji from you. But she says that I don't make pav bhaji like what you make. So I don't. But
why every chef brings a little bit of their touch to the recipe, and that recipe becomes your own.
That's what it is. So your recipe
is
your
anybody. We'd like to know now a little later is that what is the scale of the business? कि आप कितना business करते हो? What is the maximum capacity? You are looking at, I think you're doing a catering, right? And you told me you do this only on weekends.
Yeah.
So weekdays पे हेतल को फोन कर सकते हैं?
नहीं कर सकते. So I do a lot of small, like a gathering, like a party order, you know, somebody's birthday, somebody wants to give food, you know. So that's how I do. And
weekend scale of your business and next step kya hai? Abhi aap, okay, you're doing maximum 25 people, 50 people, you've done 100 then. What is the next stage for the business you're looking at?
So what I'm looking at is,
are you looking at setting up a professional catering unit? You know, making it upscale. Are you looking at training yourself and becoming professional?
Exactly. So the first step right now for another 1-2 years is what I want to do, a professional training. I want to learn under somebody, learn something. So there are certain things which you don't know, like when it comes to Asian cooking, there are certain authentic things that you need to learn, you know, you need to know. So which is what I'm going to do. But sooner or later I realized, I did my master class on Cloud Kitchen and all of that, and I realized it's not for me, because I still cannot come to terms with hiring some chef and then running a place. I mean, the personal touch, the authenticity goes. So
I'm going to take this a rank and say, you know guys, it's everyone learns from their home sometimes, and yes, even the best chefs in the world, they always say are men, but wo sab apni dadi maa, nani maa, mummy se seekhte hain, right? Aap ghar se seekhte ho, but if you're going out in the industry and you want to become professional, a little back from my story, when I restarted, I gave it all up to be with my kids, okay? A very successful cooking class career. For 10 years I stopped, because I wanted to be a soccer mom. And now my kids are 24 and 21. I re-entered the industry 13 years ago, and so you can imagine the nagging that I must have done. Trust me. So what I want to say is, when I came back into the industry, हमारे इंडिया में every career had an age.
Yeah.
हर चीज़ में एक age आती है. I don't think age should be a barrier. Right? We teach anyone from 5-year-old to 80-year-old. We've even had a 60-year-old gentleman who's come and does a professional course with us. So I found myself doing these professional courses when I traveled to London, Paris. Every year I went to upgrade myself when we started Panchkalani Studio. And suddenly it struck me that, you know what, it's really expensive, A, when you're traveling. Not everyone has the resources. B, time. You can't leave your family and go if you're if you have responsibilities. For young ones, it's okay for them to go off for 3 months, 6 months. But that other age, sometimes it's not easy to leave your family and go for 3 months and 6 months. That's when हमने वो international accreditation
आया.
So yes, agreed. आप अपने जो बनाते हो dishes, उसे एक chef look देने के लिए you need to know a professional course.
So
I'm not gonna sell myself, but it's very important to professionally learn your knife skills, your mother sauces, your stock. You know, so a professional course, whether it's a small diploma in culinary or bakery, will give you that confidence, that notch higher.
Sure.
You know, it gives you that confidence, gives you the knowledge of everything, you know, and that's something I would advise to women over here. I've done it and I think it helps, and now we are training so many other people. So yes, we are sending the best students in the industry, but again, age is not a barrier. We've got people of all age coming to us. Yes, for sure. So moving on to Chandni. Chani is a fashion designer, and we can see the fashion sense right there. She's a bit nervous right now. But Chani, I love the fact that, you know, you've taken your mother's legacy in front. It's a very sweet thing, you know. And she's a little close to my heart right now, because each one, you know, har ek ne ek ek cheez. So these girls, when they spoke to me, it was my daughter telling me, NYC cookie, NYC cookie. Mom, you need to have that class. And I could relate to it, you know. And then Heather, who's just like me, who's been learning bachpan se, and you know. And then there's Chani, who takes that fusion to the next level. Because I love to do that,
yes.
You know. And you do a little bit of fusion stuff.
Yes.
But, okay, so we'll hear something about you, and then I'm going to ask a very important quote from everyone, and we'll ask the audience the answer. So, Chani.
Hi. So, I started this before I got married. I used to never cook. I used to never even enter the kitchen. And after I got married, still
is
I...
Is your mother-in-law you?
Where is she?
Can we see her?
I think she's gone somewhere.
Aunty ji, aap yahan hain? Aapki bahu khana banati hai?
Abhi bahut banati hai.
Bahut banati hai. Bahut pakati hai.
So, pandemic really, first whole month of the pandemic, I was quite bored. I used to watch TV, do nothing else. Then I thought, why not just start getting into the kitchen, getting into the zone of cooking.
So what are your top three that you would say we should go for? The top three desserts.
Number one, my mom's kaju kesar mithai. I've named it Mama's special kaju kesar mithai. Second, I would say Nutella baklava.
Okay.
And gulab jamun mini bun cakes.
Okay. Okay.
So those are the top three best selling fusion desserts that I get. And yeah, it started off from there. And first I started this Head Over Meals by posting recipes. And I used to send over food to my friends, to my family, just to try. And they really requested me that, you know, they pushed me ahead. They told me to start something of my own. I started posting recipes. Then I started with a bake sale in July. And that went not too hit, but that was just between the friends and family. Once they started posting on social media, they started helping me.
So that was your starting point,
yes.
Basically.
That was a
turning point in your career.
Yes.
Okay, alright.
And then I started doing festivals. I started with Rakhi, then Ganpati, then Diwali. That's what I'm doing very well right now. And I don't have time in the whole day. Other than being in the kitchen.
Okay,
I
lovely.
Don't even have time to go.
So you got the best daughter-in-law award now?
I hope.
So contrary to what you do, I have an amazing mother-in-law, in fact, who makes me nashta and gives me the hand.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She does the same.
Yeah, because she knows I'm busy working out, and most of the times when I'm off for my events, she does that. So yeah, tell me, how does the girls, a quick one liner, everyone is going to tell me, ki, being a woman in this industry, being a woman entrepreneur, or being a home baker, or a home chef, what is that one thought that comes to your mind? Quickly, one line, everyone. We're going to pick up the pace, thoda, you know?
It's just the ability to be calm in the pressure that you're getting the whole day.
Mm-hmm.
And it feels good to be a boss lady.
Okay, it feels good to be a boss lady. But do you get negative sometimes comments like, oh, you're not professional? Anything negative that
no,
word has not, it's affecting you?
Till now, no, I haven't.
Oh, you haven't.
I haven't got it.
Ketan?
No, so me too neither. It's because people know me and know my cooking since.
So it's just
so
friends
it's
and family up
there. No, it's through social media when you have and when you have unknown people, word of mouth, truth, okay, I have, you know, tasted this, you know, in my friend's house, I was there. And so all the big orders and the consistent orders have always been non-friends, you know, through somebody. And they've been consistent with you. What are you cooking next? You know, when you get a message on Wednesday, dude, what's your menu on the weekend? We are waiting. That's what you love. You know,
okay.
That's what
okay.
keeps you going.
So right now you're very happy. I can see these two are very happy in their space. What about Pooja and Tulsi? What is it that you're looking out of this business? Are you happy with what it is right now? Are you happy by what you've called? Or do you want to upscale this, and what is the plan?
We're actually happy with what it is right now, but obviously we're looking for upscaling as well. And like she said, most of our orders and everything has also been through friends and family, and then people trying it at their house, and then word of mouth. And it feels really nice when you have unknown and strange strangers messaging you saying we'd like to place an order, and we're actually looking out to start delivering pan India. Like, that's the next step for us.
Oh, okay. So for that, what is the plan in action? Because you will need a little bit of technical support.
So we are actually in talks with people to understand the entire logistics of it, because like, you know, it's something we started off, but there's a lot of things that are involved with it, you know. So you need to get proper information about how to go about things, which is why we're working on the logistics right now. And hopefully very soon we'll have it pan Indian. If nature's kind enough to us, you'll have it on the shelves as well.
That's a good one, guys. That's a good one. So I want to ask a question to your mom who's sitting across there. Can we have the camera there? So Abhi, jab we can have the mic to her. Can we just pass the mic? Yes. So Pooja aur Tulsi kitchen ka mess agar karte hain nahi, I'm sure nahi karte hain, we are just joking, because even I do
a lot karte hain
at time pe. Mummy just comes at that time bringing the milk or bringing the goodies, namkeen cheeze kha le beta, itna kab se kaam karo, does she still do that? Is she doing that? Aapko kaise, I want to know from you.
बहुत
सपोर्ट करती हूँ, जब सारा रॉ मटेरियल सब देखने का रहता है क्या है क्या नहीं है, और तो सारा
मार्केटिंग
के लिए आपको भेजते हैं, बहुत वेरी
स्मार्ट. उसके साथ मैं सोशल मीडिया और इंस्टाग्राम बहुत कुछ दिस न्यू थिंग नाउ टेल मी व्हाट शुड आई डू. I was like, this is how you post a story, and she's like, she's loving it.
I know, I can understand. So, but is the whole family supporting? Matlab, father, dad, we career support.
My mother-in-law also.
Wow.
So we'll tell you a reason behind why we first, you know, go to our grandma.
Just
sorry,
we'll wait for the mic to come to you. Just a minute. Thank you. Yes.
So I'll tell you a reason why first we actually go to our grandmom is because we initially, our thought was that it's just us millennials who are going to enjoy this, you know. But the very first time when we made that, and I told my dadi, ye taste karo kaisa hai batao, like, what do you understand when you have this? And then she was like, ye bahut acha, and she loves sweet. You give her any
she must have said, guna hua sheera hai.
No, because it's a flavor. It's a flavor.
The classic one, but yeah. You know, in culinary and bakery, if you know, basic roux is what, when you roast your flour, right? Yeah. You take it to color level.
Yeah.
You got the white, you got the blonde, you got the brown, right?
Yeah.
Same thing you do in your India when you do in your sheera and atta. Right?
Yeah. Yeah.
And obviously when you're doing your cooking, of course you're adding different flavors. But you definitely are using similar concepts.
Correct.
So food has a very thin line. If
you
look at it, it's a very thin line. You have to understand that it's similar. You
absolutely
need to have that passion.
Yeah.
Okay, so quickly, a call question to everyone, and we'll go into the audience also. The sound of being an entrepreneur, what comes to your mind? Since you have the mic, let's hear.
Okay, so honestly, this was something when someone tells me, Tulsi, now you're an entrepreneur, you can actually, like, you are your own boss. That feeling is such a blessing to me, and I have learned so much just by myself, because every day has been a hurdle for me. Every day has been a new challenge altogether. And it just gives me a lot of satisfaction from inside. And I mean, it's amazing. It's just the best feeling that one can ever have.
So Pooja and Tulsi, what's the target? The next NYC ticket, are you going to trouble mom and dad to buy, or you're buying it yourself?
Buying it ourselves. Yeah. And we're sponsoring the whole family.
So what's the span we're looking at? What's the graph, the plan? How many years? 5-year plan, 2-year plan, 10-year, what is the plan?
We're actually looking, like we said, we're looking to work things out with Pan India. So maybe, hopefully, if the situation gets better and we're able to travel for tourism soon, then hopefully the next 2 years looks good.
Nice, we like the sound of that. Mahekal, plans kya hai? Upscaling ke plans kya hai?
So
who's your biggest supporter in the house?
it's my mom, as cliche as you say, but my mom has always been. I have only been looking, I don't see any men, I just saw one gentleman
behind who was really happy and laughing.
Yeah.
Who's he, which family member is he with? Who's he with?
I think all the men are from my family.
Okay, so Chani's got all the men support basically.
But I don't think it works without support even from your child. Like I have a 9-year-old daughter. So even without, like, mom, you're busy. Okay, I'm going to finish my homework. Don't bother. Yeah. So it's that little support.
Sure, I'm finishing the homework at that time.
So that also makes them so much more independent because you know that. So it's without a family support, nothing is possible. So they've always been very supportive, be it my husband, my child, my mom. And always been, mom, there's too much order, just come over, it's crazy. Okay, and she's so always there. They come back, they come, they start like, kya karna hai, and they just start over.
Oh, so it's a full kitchen full of everything. Tell me, what is this misconception, you know, about home bakers and home chefs? Do you feel that you're going to get stuck in that thing? You want to break it out? You know, because not a chef. Abnaam to luckily and not a chef. But kya aap chef banna chahte hain professionally?
Yeah. So that
still you'll continue with the same name, obviously.
Yes, I will. For sure.
Okay.
But the idea is where I want to, you know, grow into making my own studio where it's more like food is like an experience to you.
Okay. You come
experience the kind of cuisine. It's like it's food is memory, so they come make memories and go and you never forget. So where you book slots, you have different menus, you can come and try to cook that and eat your own food, and there are lots of different things. So that's a studio kind of setup that I'm looking at. And not looking at something like, you know, a catering or a cloud kitchen or anything.
Okay.
But I want to have the personal touch always there, you know, where I have more women involved, you know, hire them, teach them. Even they, you know, will be like not a chef or not having the kind of degree, but pass the knowledge to them and get them into the whole business.
Okay. So quickly, I want to Chani, tell me, in this modern day of this age, you know that the Thais have taken an upscale. No one wants a typical mithai.
Yeah.
Even the mithai boxes jo hai, abhi bahut modern ho gaye hain. You know, they've modified and they've made a fusion out of that also. Everything works. So are we looking at that kind of a concept that you are running? Are you already on that page? Yeah, aap towards that page ja rahe ho?
I am on that page and coming up is Holi. I am doing something with, if you've heard, Pragri.
Yes.
For Holi. I am trying to do something in a baklava kind of something.
Okay.
It is still to launch, but yeah, I am on the lines of doing a lot of fusion desserts with fusion packing, good quality ingredients, and just doing better and better every day.
Okay, so this is a personal question, and everyone needs to know this. You know, social media plays a very important role.
Yes. Yeah.
Now, you know, if you come to my academy, you will see, I mean, even I was very socially, you know, I was technically challenged.
Yeah.
Social media, even I had to really learn, because I had people doing it for me. And then I realized that I har ek pe depend nahi kar sakti, khud bhi karna hoga. So yes, maine kaafi kuch khud bhi seekha, which I didn't know, right? Because I come from that generation. But now the first thing, which is very important, and I don't know if you guys are doing it, toh, agar nahi kar rahe ho, toh ab aapko karna hai. A, you need to be very tech savvy. B, you need to be fully equipped. So jo aap banate ho, uski photography, the plating, the style, your props, your lighting, the mic. Yes. Do you put all of this in place or no? Because you know what? That is your selling page.
So that's what I do. My food is exactly the way it looks. My food, I do sample dishes. I do my food photography. I do all the props. I have everything in place, and then it's clicked, and the food, when it comes to you, it looks exactly like the way it's in the picture.
Did you join any online classes to
do that? I've done my photography course also, so I know about
it. Now in the pandemic?
No, I've done it before. Even photography was like, you know, something which I really like. So I'm using it now so much, you know, as much that my every picture of my food, my menu, everything is done by me.
Okay, what about you, Chani?
I would give all my credits of photography, of styling to my best friend.
Okay.
She's right there.
So can we have the camera towards her? She's constantly been shooting also. And camera turn kar lenge, unko hum le aayenge camera mein. Or you can come in front here.
Yeah.
Yes. Hi, so this is Chani's friend.
Hi, everybody. this is Amandeep here. So I've known Chandni for about 5 years, and last year when she told me that she's just starting out, I was like, oh, you don't even cook. But then I am gluten intolerant. She made custom desserts for me. So anything and everything she makes for selling, she does it custom for me. And I was like, you know what, we have to like take it upscale and we have to do everything we can. Like she mentioned, she started off just in the kitchen at home, and then when the festive hampers and festivals came in, we put in a lot of effort into
styling, props,
photography, content, marketing. So yeah, we've been doing it together since.
That's great. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for that support. So over to Pooja and Tulsi, who does the styling bit and everything and the photography.
So she looks into the whole photography and the styling bit. And the whole social media aspect is something that I look into, because I've been in the media and advertising agency since past 2 years.
Oh, lovely.
So I exactly know, it was a blessing for us, since we exactly knew what path to take and how to go about it. And we could market it really well. Like, we still are.
Lovely. Okay, so quickly, I would love to turn to the audience and ask them if they would like to. Koi questions agar aapke man mein hai. I mean, my mom can also ask, which I need them quietly back here. And anyone and everyone who would like to ask questions, we'd like to take those questions either from me or from these panelists here. So please, the mic towards you all now. Yes, yes. We'll just pass the mic.
Actually, I live in the United States, friends with Hegel, in a family. And I can sort of say that Hegel's mom, we have also eaten very delicious dishes a long time ago. But I'm just curious, because my daughter also was living at home for a while, worked from home, suddenly became a cook and was trying. Honestly, I want to ask maybe all of you, that do you really see yourself sustaining this beyond the pandemic and, once a full-fledged life comes back? Now, do you see your guys really...
That's a lovely question, ma'am. Can we have a name? So, there's a lovely question from Ishani. And Ishani, I want to give you this answer. So, I'm just going to wait for them to turn over. तो यू नो व्हाट, जब पैंडेमिक में सब लोग शेफ और कुक बन गए एंड दिलजीत दोसांझ भी बन गया, आई एम लाइक, अब प्रोडक्शन जब नेक्स्ट मूवी होगी तो पता चला प्रोडक्शन में खाना भी उसके यूनिट से, उसका ही आ रहा है यूनिट में. तो थोड़ा आई वाज लाइक, ये क्या उठे उपटाए सब लोग शेफ हो रहे हैं. इट्स नॉट अ वेरी इजी इंडस्ट्री. येस, यू नो, सस्टेनेंस इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट. मेनी ऑफ देम हैव स्टार्टेड एंड देन काफ़ी फिजल आउट भी हो गए. बट ठीक है, वो टाइम पे और कुछ करने को नहीं था, हमें तो दूसरा भी बहुत काम करना पड़ता था. बट या द क्वेश्चन
इज नॉट जस्ट, आई एम आल्सो टॉकिंग अबाउट नॉट सस्टेनिंग द बिजनेस बट सस्टेनिंग योर इंटरेस्ट
इन. यस, ट्रू. अग्री. सो क्विकली वी विल गिव एवरीवन अ मिनट, लाइक जस्ट अ फ्यू सेकंड्स टू आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन. सो फर्स्ट अप विद द माइक, हूएवर इज.
सो वी फील वी
दैट्स ओके. थोड़ा खाओ, थोड़ा फेंको,
नया फोन आएगा.
सो वी फील दैट वी विल डेफिनेटली बी इन द मार्केट. एंड आई टेल यू व्हाई, स्पेशली बिकॉज यू नो व्हेन फर्स्टली द फर्स्ट बैच गोज, इट गोज टू योर फ्रेंड्स, योर फैमिली, एंड देन यू गेट द थर्ड पार्टी ऑर्डरिंग फ्रॉम यू ऑल टुगेदर. बट व्हेन योर ऑर्डर्स आर कमिंग ऑन रिपीट फ्रॉम द सेम पर्सन, दैट्स द यू नो द सैटिस्फैक्शन दैट यू गेट. ओके, दिस हैज बीन लाइक्ड बाय the audience, and people are actually very interested in this whole new concept that we've come up with. So that is a motivation for us to keep going and work harder.
But Tulsi, you know what, in earlier, before the pandemic, you know, there were a lot of B2B exhibitions and smaller exhibitions, B2C also happening, which used to give you all a ground. Now today, it's really nice of Nature's Basket to, you know, let you come out with your story. So events like this, yes, but your product has to speak. स्पीक फॉर यू मतलब जो प्रोडक्ट टेस्ट करेगा तो ही आपको पता चलेगा राइट सो एग्जीबिशंस डेफिनेटली बिकॉज ऑफ द पैंडेमिक हैव कम डाउन लाइक लिटरली 1/10 हो गए आई नो वेरिंग एंड ऑल एंड वो सब स्टार्ट हो गए बट स्टिल द कॉस्ट फैक्टर इज हायर सो हाउ डू यू लुक एट टेकिंग दैट बिजनेस टू द नेक्स्ट लेवल व्हाट इज द आइडिया इन योर माइंड क्विकली इफ यू कैन गिव अस दैट
So we,
because यहाँ बहुत सारे दूसरे लोग भी हैं जिनको इंस्पायर ये स्टोरी इंस्पायर कर सकती है राइट सो लेट्स हियर एंड यू नो रीच आउट टू ईच अदर
सो एट द मोमेंट बिकॉज ऑब्वियसली वी आर नॉट वी आर स्टिल इन दैट फेज ऑफ नॉट गोइंग आउट दैट मच सो वी आर एट द मोमेंट वी आर ऑब्वियसली नॉट लुकिंग आउट लाइक यू सेड फॉर एग्जीबिशंस और वी एक्चुअली गॉट कॉल्स फ्रॉम कॉलेजेस फॉर देयर फेस्ट एज वेल वी थॉट इट वॉज अ ग्रेट अपॉर्चुनिटी बट अगेन We're in that
Most phase. Most of them are even online still.
Yeah, so which is why we don't want to do it right now. We want to actually be in that space where it's open. We can connect with you. We can speak with you because it's completely eggless. We don't use preservatives. And I, as domates, I want to understand what your taste is like. Are you allergic to something? I want to have that personal connect with you to suggest a flavor to you. And understand you as a customer, you know, and that happens face to face for sure, a lot better. And even in fact, when we receive messages on Instagram or Facebook, I take 10 minutes to speak to that person to understand what they're looking at and then suggest something accordingly. I don't want them to just feel like, acha, I like chocolate, let me order chocolate. No, let me understand your other flavors and likings that you have and then let me suggest it accordingly as well.
So with this kind of personalized attention, what is your maximum number business stuff?
At the moment...
You sell smaller tubs like what? What is the,
at the moment,
packaging like?
At the moment, we have jars of 300 grams that go out.
What's the maximum number you've done?
In a day, I think we've done about 40? For the hampers, yeah.
No, so in a week, what is your number and what's your projection ahead?
Honestly, I haven't looked at for what.
Okay,
what is
so
it in a
for
week?
You to look into this because
yeah,
if you're seriously sustaining this business, you want to take it to the next level. That's the question. Aapke dimag mein aana chahiye, right? Okay, over to Chandni. Chandni, are you going to survive this? Passion that you have right now, ise next level leke jaoge ya do teen festivals khatam ho jayenge iske baad again back to not cooking in the kitchen.
No, definitely I am going to continue this. I am every day in the kitchen innovating new stuff. You can ask my mother-in-law.
Mother-in-law ji, please bataiye kitna khila rahi hai, kitna paka rahi hai. Aap beech mein gum ho gaye the, hum aapke liye wait kar rahe the.
So, yeah.
Do you also, आप इसके लिए नाश्ता बनाते हो कोकी बना के खिलाते हो
नहीं या कुछ भी अच्छा
नहीं है कुछ भी अच्छा
सो या माय होल प्लान इज टू गेट इनटू द B2B जोन एंड आई वांट टू स्टार्ट केटरिंग टू केटरर्स टू रेस्टोरेंट्स एक्स वाई जेड आई एम FSSAI रजिस्टर्ड
ओके
एंड आई वांट टू गो टू अ नेक्स्ट लेवल आई वांट टू enhance my hampers basically
but you're single handedly doing it in the kitchen
everything no helper
so
nothing.
Then how will you upscale agar aapko kal aapko 1000
eventually
boxes ke orders aate hain ya 5000 ke aate hain to aap kaise karoge
abhi tak I have done 60 hampers till at one stretch
okay
so till now I am doing well I am doing day and night where I can't go to my fashion
yeah, but you see, at this point of level, jab aap 60 kar rahe ho, that's not going to suffice the business to sustain because marketing cost hi itni badh jaate hai, right? So you're not taking back anything.
What is your, you need to make a plan jahan aapka break even point kahan hai.
It is, but I just need to get that confidence in me.
Because you don't have any overheads. You're doing it from your own kitchen, right? The minute you step out, your overheads will increase.
My plans are
then that 60 is not going to survive.
My plans are to open a kitchen. I have the space. I have everything. I have the support from my husband, from my dad, from my brother, from my mother-in-law. Everything. We have everything. But it's just that I am not ready to get out there.
Okay.
As this
so,
is my first time.
I would like to give her an advice at this point of time. Even before the pandemic, you know, a year, 2 years before that only, cloud kitchens anyway bahut important ho gaye.
Yeah.
Because what happens is ki overheads, everyone thinks it's very easy. Trust me, it's the toughest job to be an entrepreneur.
Yeah.
If someone asks me, I started from a garage 13 years ago, one small garage, and I told my husband,
कि what if I don't make the money, the rent is so much, this is a, he said this is a gift for you, आप हफ्ते में दो क्लास भी करोगे ना, I'm okay with it, but I said नहीं, मैं तो सिंधी हूँ और I have a very strong बनिया mind also कि नहीं मैं, you know if a business can't pay for itself then no offense to anyone here, मैं हमेशा अपने लिए भी बोलती हूँ, I tell my students I'm a Sindhi but I'm not a conjuice, but listen, no offense to anyone, I just want to give this as a pure advice, you know, कि अगर business घर से जा रहा है पैसे तो that business is not worth doing. Yeah. You need to make sure that you take back. Okay? Yeah. Very, very important. From that garage, I moved on to buying another space, a bigger space. And then we moved on to, obviously, my TV shows happened. I've done a lot of TV shows with Food Food, with C-Zest, with Living Foods, with TLC. But having said that, my core business is teaching. I love being a teacher. मैं ये girls को बता रही थी कि, you know, many of the times in the starting, I did a few consultancy projects, but what made me more happy was just teaching. You know, my teacher once told me, the more you share, the more you learn.
Yes.
So, your business is very opposite of my business. Yes. Means, aap apna jo ace of space hai, wo apne paas rakhoge. Your recipe is your secret.
Yes.
With me, my recipe is never a secret.
Yeah.
Wherever I teach, has to be out there for you to be able to make it.
Yes.
So, we are, that way we are opposites, of course. But I chose that life. And being a woman in this industry, it's the toughest. I'm being very honest. It's not easy. There are many places where you're not recognized. And agar aap chef ho, thank God I have professional degree with me because I did that backwards, you know. I told my husband that I don't want to be called a home chef and mujhe professional training chahiye. And I did that. And then I opened the school where I could give others also that opportunity because I realized that not everyone can go to London, leave their family. But what I'm saying is it's really, really tough. And people don't recognize you because you're teaching. Okay. आप अगर chef हो और आपके पास restaurant है या आप you know कुछ खोल रहे हो, recognition आती है. So there is disparity in the industry in many levels and that happens in every level. So A, investment should be really low, always.
Yeah.
And it always helps to have the best of knowledge of ingredients, which you know Nature's Basket is really good at.
Yes.
I mean, अगर आप सिर्फ गुड शुगर में जाना चाह रहे हो तो यू हैव द होल रेंज, यू कैन सी व्हाट्स अवेलेबल, यू वांट योर कोकोनट ऑयल, यू हैव द होल रेंज, यू हैव योर होल ऑर्गेनिक रेंज, एवरीथिंग, वेदर यू आर बेकिंग, व्हाटएवर यू आर डूइंग, वेदर यू आर डूइंग वीगन कीटो, नॉलेज ऑफ इंग्रेडिएंट्स वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, नॉलेज ऑफ इक्विपमेंट्स. तो आप छोटे से छोटी जगह लो, अपने घर से लो, बट यू नो दैट वन प्रोफेशनल अवन विल टेक यू 10 फोल्ड्स, राइट? यू डोंट नीड टू डू अ गुड इंटीरियर्स, बट दैट इक्विपमेंट विल. And the training, professional training. Automatically, when you start your knife skills, that one dish starts looking 10 notches higher.
Yes. Yes.
So just a little advice for all three of you all.
Yeah.
We'll take some more questions from the audience. If there's anyone else, koi puchna chahta hai kuch? Anyone? We don't bite. So can we have any questions from the audience? Chandni, we see a lot of your family behind. Would they like to ask anything?
They are all busy amongst them, sir.
Yeah. Did you not train them and come? Ghar jaake no baglawa for you. All right. So any more questions you could take? Can we take any questions from the live? Koi live mein questions aa rahi hai, toh hum udhar le sakte hain. If there's anyone giving a question, we'd love to take a question. Yes. Would you like to ask something? Yes. Should we just pass for the mic, please? Yes.
Thank you. So like you said that you are from...
What's your name, darling?
My name is Samita.
Samita. Okay, Samita, a little about you first.
Okay. So I work in an advertising agency.
Okay, lucky.
That way we connect.
Yeah.
And side by side, I'm a big foodie, so I have my own page called That Foodie Mumbai.
Okay, so see, we've got another person who's really making it big in this... doing two double businesses and it's amazing. Alright, so tell us about you.
So, I have this question, like right now you guys are doing really well, you say, and we have nowhere to go. So for me to start something of my own full time, I have this question, like during my job I get my leaves, I get to go somewhere. So I don't have to worry about, you know, cash and flow and everything. But if you start something of your own and if you plan, you know, you want to take a break or you want to go travel somewhere, that time how are you planning to manage?
Anyone wants to answer that question? Yeah, take the mic from you.
So honestly, I think it's a great thing that both of us are into this together, and we'll definitely plan our leaves and plan our schedule accordingly. So the day I'm not available, she takes it up, and the day she is not available, I take it up. That's how we've been till now. We've been working like that because both of us have been really caught up with our actual professions.
To add to that, I have another job. I teach. So I teach French. So my sessions are there in the morning. And then she handles everything otherwise. And the days that she's not... So basically, it's not taking leaves, but it's just not having her around, right? Or me around. So when she's on her actual leaves, I take it up. And when I'm not there, she takes it up. So that's how we manage. But like she rightly said, we will for sure have a time in the future where we'll need people to help us with it, and that we kind of foresee soon.
Yeah. So what I'm getting it is that these two fall back on each other. You're alone.
Yeah.
Yeah. Chani would like to give you an answer.
I think to balance between two jobs, you really need to plan yourself. First of all, that, you know, itna time I want to give to baking, itna time I want to give to my other job. That's what I do. I go to my, still, whenever I have orders, I still plan to go for 3 hours to my store. Maybe it's just for lunch, but I do that. But whenever I want a leave, I feel self-care is more important, and you really need to do that. So take the break whenever you should.
Yeah.
Whenever you need it, you should take the break.
Is that answering your question?
Yeah, to an extent.
And honestly, time management is the key. And you can, with food blogging, because we've also been a part of it, it is a task. Honestly, you'll cook, okay, you have your time there, but what about the photography? Your food needs to look extremely appealing for someone to actually come to your page and see that, okay, you know, this is something they've made and we want to try it, or we would like to take in recipe.
And that takes a lot more time, you know, setting up the props and everything.
That's like
that takes
a
lot
process.
More time.
It's a whole day process.
Take breaks
from
those days also.
Yeah, so these are the things what you're saying, being a home chef or doing it at this scale. That's why these are the glitches which we need to, you know,
overcome.
Is later on, that's when you get, you know, more people or go ahead and want to do. So you do take your breaks, being a weekend kitchen. You know, or you know, whenever you have any specific order, I can take that during the weekdays. But you know, other than that, you know that when you are not working this weekend, you are not there, you make it up to it. But later on, when you grow, you will have to plan better. That's the only thing. You hire more people, plan better, and that's what I mean. It's just the beginning, I feel. It's like we've just started, say, it's not even like a year now.
Yeah.
So it's still a lot to learn, still a lot to do, to experience, you know, all these things that's going to come our way.
Till the time you feel like you can manage, with obviously doing your time management, you can do it, go for it, do it. But because of that thought of what will I do, don't delay the process of starting it.
Yeah.
You know, it doesn't matter if you have an... I mean, just because we're sisters, it's working out for us. What if we were on our own, you know? So it doesn't matter. Don't delay that process. It's now or never, and that's something we realized in the pandemic. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
So to conclude to that, I think I'd say that, see, anything that is something that you really want to seriously do, your passion, if you have to follow, it's never going to be easy, right? You'll have to give it your heart, soul, everything. Always have to juggle. Don't give up that work because that's giving you the money to make this continue. You have to learn to juggle. Definitely get helping hands. We all have our moms, mom-in-laws, sister-in-laws all coming in together. So please find your moms and sister-in-laws and get them to come and help you. I think that will be the easier starting point for you. I'd like to conclude this beautiful session that we had with these wonderful girls. And I'd like to say... These women are truly women who have, you know, who challenged this whole scenario thanks to the COVID situation. And really thank you to Nature's Basket for giving us this presence, this amazing initiative ki, you know, to recognize ki ye aap kar rahe ho and you've done a change, you've done something, whether it was COVID or non-COVID. We're going to take it to the next level. Definitely in a couple of years, we'll see all these three, we'll see their products will be here on the shelves. And we'll see hers as well. we'll see Hetal having a beautiful cloud kitchen, you know, scaling up her business and probably at all the best possible weddings that we're looking at. ये सब तब होगा जब ये सब मुझे टेस्टिंग के लिए
भेजेंगे
नॉलेज ऑफ इंग्रेडिएंट्स एंड उसके लिए आपके पास नेचर्स बास्केट है तो प्लीज अवेल ऑफ दैट अपॉर्चुनिटी दैट दे गिवन यू एंड यू कैन कम योर टेक योर बिजनेस टू द नेक्स्ट लेवल इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड वंस अगेन थैंक यू सो मच I would like to sign off now. Oh, thank you so much for that. Thank you. We're all here with the help and support of our family members. Like they say, women, jise bolte hai na ki they would help each other. We've had our women, but I can truly say that ki even the men in our life have helped us and they've supported us. And thank you so much. And right now, this wonderful audience who's there with us, the people who are there watching us online. Guys, if you are not there, then we are not there. Thank you so much. I'm Shandrati Vaswani. And have a wonderful weekend. Sunday is already over. Have a great week ahead. And lots of love and lots of passion. Happy cooking and happy baking.